Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video I will show you some tips how to customize your Xcode, specifically Xcode 9. So without further ado, let's get started. So, once you download Xcode and you start getting familiarized with it, you will find something like this. Let's create a new project here. I will say a single view app. I will just drop this onto my desktop here. This is just a little example. So once you open, let's say viewcontroller.swift, you will have this white screen that can be annoying while you try to write code 8 or even 10 hours a day. It will most certainly kill your eyes on the long run. So what I advise you to do is to change the theme of Xcode background and fonts and the color of those fonts. So what you need to do is go to Xcode here and select preferences. And here, select fonts and colors. And as you can see, the basic one is selected. Now, let's just select midnight. Oh, cool one. Or maybe dusk. Dusk is my preferred one because it has all of these nice colors that I like to use. And more even, you could set the spacing to tight, and you can see, or maybe relaxed. I'm good with normal. And of course you can select the vertical bar cursor. I just leave it as is because it is much more convenient for these tutorials. Okay, next up is to go, and of course you can set the console too. Okay, and one more thing before I continue, you can also customize each type of text here on the colors and the fonts and the size, of course. But I will just leave it to the basic dusk theme. Okay, next up is the text editing. Well, as you can see, here are four spaces of indentation. I really like to use two spaces for indentation because it makes my code much more constrained and more easy to read. So what I like to do is go to indentation, and for the tab width I just choose 2, and to indent width I choose 2, and indent wrap lines by 2 spaces. Now, what this does is whenever a new line is created or you just press return, only 2 spaces are set for indentation. Okay, let's check this out. Okay, let me just write here another comment, and as you can see, I hit return and the comment starts off with 2 spaces. Good stuff, but now some of our code is with four spaces of indentation. What I really like to do is just Command A to select all, Command X to clear all and copy to our clipboard, and then Command V to paste it all in again. And now, as you can see, these 2 spaces for indentation has been automatically added. Okay, now one last thing that you should know is which line of code you are typing in. This is good for debugging or maybe just to memorize which function is where. Well, it is a good thing to do. And let's open up our preferences again and go to text editing and select editing, and here show line numbers. Check this in and you will see that all the line numbers had been added to our code. Okay, that is all that I suggest for a starter to customize your Xcode. Go ahead, and if you like other preferences that you would like to share with the Rebeloper community, go ahead and type in the comments below. Let me know what kind of themes or other setups you like in your Xcode setup. Now, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more videos of me about these kind of tips and tricks, go ahead and click the subscribe button down below if you haven't already done so. And click the bell button to keep up with the notifications when new videos are coming out. Now, that's it for me today. I will see you in the next one.